Hello and welcome to the second video tutorial on using the search function in display screens in Maze. In the first video we introduced the search group of icons displayed on the ribbon of all display in batch screens. In the search results list, the columns shown can be selected from a list of selectable fields. Search results fields are accessed by right-clicking in the search results list and are selected by placing a tick next to the required field. Any field displayed may also be deselected. The results list may be sorted by any of the displayed fields in the list by clicking on the column header. Navigation through the records is in the current sorted order in the results list. Maze will automatically undertake a wildcard search on the text you entered by appending the percentage sign wildcard character. For example, if BA is used in the surname field, the result will be the records of all students with the surname starting with BA, followed by any other characters. The asterisk or percentage sign wildcards can also be used within your search value. If you use wildcards, percentage or asterisk within your search value, they will be replaced with one or more characters. For example, if you search for BA asterisk N or BA percentage sign N in the surname field, the result will be the records of all students with a surname starting with BA, followed by any other characters and ending with the character N. If you use a question mark or underscore wildcard within your search value, they will be replaced with a single character. All other characters must be known. For example, if you search for BA question mark NES or BA underscore NES in the surname field, the result will be records of all students with a surname starting with BA, followed by one other character and ending with characters NES. Wildcards, question mark or underscore may also be used at the end of a search value if all other characters are known. Searching for ABBOT question mark in the surname field returns students with a surname starting with ABBOT plus one additional unknown character. You can search for null values in a field by right-clicking on the field and choosing the equals null item. Executing the search will return all records that have a null value in the field and match any other search criteria entered into other fields. This is a handy way to ensure that all records have had this field completed. This example demonstrates searching for records in a grid screen. I'm going to search for students in 10.1. You can scroll through the search results using any of the methods described in the first tutorial. The grid will only display those lines where a student is in 10.1. To display the full transaction history for the family, click the refresh button. When starting to navigate through the records again, the grid will only display those lines where a student is in 10.1. Your search results may be viewed in worksheet with either all columns or the fields that may be shown in the results list. From worksheet, the records may be printed and or saved using a quick list report, exported to an Excel spreadsheet, and you can also modify the query further using SQL or query by design. These functions are not covered in detail in this tutorial. I'm searching for the eldest student of each family. To view the search results in a worksheet, simply select the View in Worksheet hyperlink. This will display the search results using all of the field headings in the search fields list. If you select the Show All Fields in Worksheet checkbox and then select the View in Worksheet hyperlink, then all field headings in the table will be displayed in Worksheet. You can export to Excel and then save as an Excel file or create a quick list report. Please refer to the search feature Maze User Manual for further information. Thank you for viewing this presentation.